These joke intros are barely worth it. Welcome back to Banjo Kazooie Nuts and Bolts.
Wow.
Yeah. I had a long time to come up with that one. That's the best I could do.
It's been a long 2 years since the last video, but we're back.
It really has. Alright, so this is Logbox. I've forgotten all the names of all the stages. Logbox 720 Act 4? Yes.
That sounds right.
Logbox 720 Act 4. And because it's Act 4, so notably, after every Act 3 of a level, it gets notably more difficult, and this video is going to be a good display of that.
Okay. So Act 3 is always the boss act, right?
Act 3 is usually the boss act. I'm going to say usually, because I know if I say yes, later on there'll be a thing where it's like, actually, it's Act 4 or Act 5 or something. I don't know.
Okay.
So we got to do a job for the old Jolly Dodger.
Is that what that is? I thought that was like supposed to be some Neo or something.
No, it's Jolly Roger, but they've changed his name, given him sunglasses and a trench coat.
Well, I mean, in today's world, where you need all your video games to be made for adults, quote unquote.
Quote unquote. So here we have a vehicle some may remember from a previous video. Gonna make a very slight adjustment to it. Pretty straightforward adjustment. I'm gonna put some high grip wheels on there because you need those. Add some extra guns because that's always good to have those.
Yeah.
Put some propellers on and we're all good. We're all good because this level is all about flying around, and it's hell. Yeah, that's great. So. The grunt bots, it's actually not about flying around. I remembered I made the adjustments and then went, nah, fuck that. So the grunt bots are attacking like the important parts of the console.
Okay.
And we basically have to stop them. And we have to score 10 points. And for some reason, I went through this whole mission thinking, man, this is the worst. They're not even giving me any indication of, like, what I've even got to do. It's right there. It's right there. I don't know why I didn't see it. Honestly.
Well, I mean,
I was kind of disappointed in myself when I realized.
It has a number counter, but it's not, like, directly indicated what that's for, so.
No, yeah. I worked it out eventually. It's not completely clear. But it's like number of points you have to score. Like, I guess it's number of enemies you have to defeat.
Yeah.
And I suppose it's also relative to how fast you do it. I think that's what gets you the trophy. I don't know. Honestly, this mission's really confusing.
Yeah. Because it's like a tower defense sort of mission, but then, like, almost. You can end it really quickly.
Yeah, so. You could end it really quickly by just kind of hanging out. Well, I don't think hanging out in one spot would work because I think there's only a certain amount of enemies that will spawn in one area.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter. We got the trophy. We got your fucking trophy, goddammit. This game's gonna be death of me. Alright, I did it.
I don't think... Shouldn't this guy be not happy that the code's bug-free? Because he's like a lizard, so doesn't he eat bugs?
I guess. That's pretty convenient, actually. He could just eat the bugs.
Yeah.
He wouldn't even have to do any testing. He'd just be like, hey, just take care of that. Thanks, it's good.
I guess you'd call him a real beta male.
Oh.
Why is he gonna be a red bear?
I don't know. It's something about. It was something to do with this. It was something to do with like a team name, I think.
Okay.
Or something like.
Oh,
that.
I get it. Cause he's gonna fly, so it's like Red Baron.
Yeah.
Fuck you, Rare.
Fucking Rare. Anyway. So we're gonna do, yeah, okay, that's what I thought was gonna happen. So what happened was I did build this plane.
Uh-huh.
Which is called Top Mume.
Okay.
Now you know what the plane's called. That was my excellent name for it. What happened was, in the middle of the recording, I got up and went to do something else and stopped the recording, came back, started playing, forgot to push record again.
Oh.
Whoops, had to go back and just redo the mission. This one was fine. The only bit of this I missed was building the plane. But another bit, I completely finished the mission and everything, and then went, oh, whoops.
Well, can you redo the missions?
I can still redo them, but, like, we'll be missing a cutscene.
Oh.
That happens, critical story cutscene. about something that Klongo does, or something, I don't know.
I didn't even know this game had a story.
It doesn't.
No.
Not really. It's the same. It's like you just gotta collect them jiggies, get the jiggies, and open the worlds, and then you win. Congratulations. Except it's not as good as, I don't know.
Yeah, because there aren't like really any stakes. It's just
not really. I mean, like Gruntilda's like right there the whole time. She's kind of hanging out, like. Oh.
And Logbox or Log isn't really a villain, so.
No, he's not. So it's really weird in that regard.
Yeah. Oh no, don't crash against it. Oh.
Too late. Couldn't stop.
Can't stop, won't stop. Oh. No.
Yeah, I used the jet there, and we still haven't legitimately gotten a jet yet.
Right.
At least, I'm not sure if at this point in the game we should have gotten a jet legitimately. Maybe not. I'm looking at how far away our car is.
Yeah.
Also, for no good reason. If you don't, like, her plane's super fast.
Uh-huh.
And I'm of the opinion that if you don't have a jet, you just won't beat her.
Okay.
Because you see, at the start of that race, I, like, use the jet to, like, fly underneath her, and that's how I beat her. But I think it's, like, one of those missions, because there are a couple of missions where it's, like, you kind of just have to come back later when you have better parts.
Yeah.
Not so great.
Oh, neither is this.
No, this isn't. This is some bad driving by me. I apologize. But we got there in the end.
Well, that's all that counts.
As you can see, the jiggy is kind of grayed out. Let's build this already.
Oops.
So what we're gonna do is we're either gonna use a pre-existing vehicle. Yeah, same vehicle that I already made a modification to.
I want to point out that you call that vehicle more like Mr. Fuck, so you could race against Mr. Fit when the far better title would have been more like Mr. Shit.
I'm sorry.
You better
messed
be.
Up. Okay, this one, I definitely modified it so that it can fly, and I added the squirter. That's what it's called.
Good. I'm glad, honestly.
So we didn't. I don't think we got an explanation of what this mission is. So basically, Klongo fucked something up,
uh-huh.
And this ball thing dropped down, and that's bad for some reason. So we have to use the squirter, and we start out with some fluid already in it, but then we have to fly over to this pool, take a very brief dip, and then just kind of fly back over. It's kind of tedious and not really very fun.
Yeah. Oh, we only have to do a dip once.
We have to do it more than once, actually, because, like, what you can't see is there's, like, a few pixels left in that bar. So you actually have to fly over, like, twice.
Jeez.
It's very annoying.
But isn't there another one of these pools near the floor?
No, I don't think so. I think this is the closest one.
What's that in the back there? Can you go dip in that? Or is that?
I don't think so. It's behind a wall.
Alright.
I think that wall actually goes from like one wall, like there's like that glass, I think it goes from one wall to the other. I don't think you could get to it. You'd start to fly over it. Even if there was a pool there, which I don't think there is.
What happened to make Klongo so tiny in this game?
I don't know, he's like normal, yeah, he's like normal person size.
Yeah, he's like one Banjo
game.
Height now.
Yeah, whereas in the previous games he was way, way bigger than Banjo.
Yeah.
So that is kind of one of the weird things about this game that you kind of touched on, is that, like, the stakes in this game, like, they're almost kind of non-existent.
Yeah.
Like, because, yeah, Grunty's just kind of hanging out. She hasn't stolen anything from us. There's nothing we need to get back from her. And the... It's like, what's the big hurry? Like, can we just kind of hang out in Showdown Town? Can we just make a new life for ourselves there?
Yeah.
Not really. Because in the previous games, it's like, you know, like, Tootie's been kidnapped, and then also, the Grunty sisters are gonna blow up the island, and they've also killed Bottles, so it's like, those are the stakes there. What are the stakes here, exactly?
The only stakes related to this game are the ones that Banjo fans want to put Rare employees on after this game.
You could say that.
That's really violent, so don't.
Yeah, so maybe we'll
you could go
so
to jail for that.
Yeah, we could. Oh, I'm going to have to cut that out. So this is another mission where we've got the squirter again. Mm-hmm. They really want us to become familiar with that mechanic for some reason.
They want you to stop being a squirt and start being a real adult.
Yeah, apparently. So, Jordan, what is your overall opinion of this game? Because I know it differs from mine, so let's have a discussion about that.
Well, I've never, like, I don't have any nostalgia that's tied to Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie. Like, yeah. I played Banjo-Kazooie a little bit at a friend's house when I was younger, but not really enough to get attached to it. Mm. So I think this game's alright. Like, it definitely has flaws, but I think on the whole, it's like an experience where there's plenty of fun to be had, but it does,
for sure, yeah,
it does have its flaws. I think it's much more of a flawed game than Banjo-Kazooie is, at least. Mm. But I think that it's roughly on the same level of, like, conciseness that Banjo-Tooie was at.
Hmm. I'd be inclined to agree if... I would say that if the levels weren't, like, weird, like, it's so weird the way the levels are chopped up into acts.
Yeah.
Like, I don't quite understand why that's necessary. Mm-hmm. It feels a little bit like, I don't know, maybe they just didn't have enough room to, like, fit all the missions into one,
yeah,
one area, so they had to break it up into acts so that they could have, like, enough missions in one area. That would be my best guess.
But, like, the environment doesn't change every time you go into a new act, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Yeah, so I assume it's like a RAM thing then. They can't have probably all the missions loaded into the memory.
Mm. But, like, I'm gonna act like Banjo-Kazooie, like, as a game is perfect, because it's not.
No.
Like, absolutely it's not. It, like, I will say it's not aged well. Like, even I can look past the rose-tinted glasses and be like, look, no, it really... I love it. Absolutely, I adore it, but, like, I can't look past the fact that, like, it has not aged well. Like, gameplay-wise, graphics-wise, I'd say it's looking better than some of the N64 games are nowadays.
Yeah, I'd agree with that.
But gameplay-wise, there's definitely some things in it that could be better, for sure.
I think one thing about this game that I wouldn't really say that it bugs me or that I think it's bad, but I think it's to the detriment of the game, is that the maps are all really big, and because of that, almost all the missions are, like, listed on the radar, so that you don't spend, like, hours looking around. But as a direct result of that, it's, like, really hard to get acquainted with the levels, because you're never, like, expected to go look around for yourself.
Yeah, that was one of the issues I said in one of the earlier episodes, is it kind of takes away that kind of feeling of, okay, I get to explore for myself. It's like, no, it's all just put out in front of you. You know where everything is instantly. Yeah.
So you're never given a chance, or you're never, implored to, like, really experience the level you're on your own.
So vehicle is my fucking masterpiece.
This vehicle could have been its own level in the past game.
I don't know if you realize what it is yet, Jordan.
I... No? Hold on.
Think about if it was flipped the other way.
Flipped the other way? What do you mean by that?
I built it wrong. I knew this was gonna happen.
Oh, so it's like mirrored, like, left to right?
Like, no. Like, if the pink bit was facing us rather than away from us.
Alright, hold on. I'm gonna... Oh,
Oh, did you see it?
Is it Sonic?
It's Sonic's head.
Oh god.
It's a Sonic head.
Well,
because we have to push those buttons fast.
I mean, it looks like it controls about as well as a Sonic game.
This is the one thing I will say, it controls like utter shit. It's so bad. I only made it for a joke. Because when I was like, okay, I'm going to let's play this game, I was like, what's one thing that I can do that will be amazing? And I was like, well, I can draw a Sonic pretty well, so I'm going to apply that to the game.
Oh, dear. So is this like only powered by the jet, or is there something else as well?
The jet is basically, at the moment, because it's made out of 50% heavy blocks.
Oh, dear.
Because I used all the light blocks at about half of the amount of heavy blocks.
Oh, wait, it has two propellers. I just noticed
it has
that.
Propellers, yeah. As well, but like the jet is the main thing that's making it go.
Yeah, because I was like thinking, how is it keeping that altitude with just the jet while it's going so slow?
No, it's the propellers.
Okay.
There you go. I'm gonna put this out there now. That's probably gonna be the peak of things I build in this game, unless people have suggestions. Because honestly, when it comes to making vehicles in this game, I'm running out of ideas.
More like Hogbox 720.
Oh man. Oh yeah, but people are completely welcome to give me some kind of, you know, recommendations for stuff I should try to build. Because last time, like when I was last recording this, I was like, oh man, I cannot think of any kind of new or creative ideas. The well's dried up already.
Oh, I was gonna suggest
episodes in.
I was gonna suggest you make one that looks like a meme, but if it has to be creative, then I guess that's out of the picture.
No, I can try that.
No, don't worry about it.
Do our best.
I mean, by which I mean don't do that until like you get Val back.
Okay.
And then you can use the memeacle.
Yeah, the memeacle. Okay, yeah, that's what I'm gonna call it now. what were you saying before that happened?
I was talking about that you're never implored to go like explore the level on yourself and really become familiar with it.
Yeah, that's because that's the main thing, and I'm repeating myself at this point, but like that is like the main thing about Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, especially Banjo-Tooie, which was so big and it had so many different places to explore, and it felt like a real kind of adventure.
Yeah,
because there was so many different places and things to see and do.
So much to see.
Yeah. So then this game comes along and it kind of removes that, and it's like, oh,
no.
Really? Oh. Oh well.
Well, there's still plenty of stuff to do. It's just.
Yeah. It's in terms of like actually, you don't really you can explore if you want, but it's like it kind of takes the need for exploration out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's also the fact that like the levels are all really big to accommodate vehicles. Well, it's the other way around. Like, the vehicles are there to accommodate
the vehicles.
The
vehicles are accommodating their fucking huge
Yeah,
levels.
But, like, the problem is they made all these really big levels, I suppose, because they wanted the game to be, like, Banjo-Tooie, but bigger.
Yeah.
But then, like, there's so much nothing in the levels. Like, there's so much empty space in all of them.
Mm. This is a little bit better in terms of empty space.
Yeah.
For sure. But Naughty Acres is just absolutely full of empty space. It's just like, you couldn't think of anything? Like, nothing to go in this empty space? Okay, well.
Well, even then, like, this level is, like, it's filled. Like, there's stuff everywhere, but most of it's, like, stuff that's not important. Like, it's just obstacles.
Yeah. And there's a level later on, which I think is an even worse, example of the amount of empty space in this game. It's really bad.
Oh.
It's like, yeah, we'll get to it eventually, but like it's not good in terms of how much empty space is in the level. Oh hey, I remembered to put the high grip wheels on.
Oh nice.
Yeah, it's really bad for empty spaces.
Yeah.
People probably know what level I'm talking about as well, but we'll get to it eventually for those that don't.
I never got far enough into this game to have any idea. Whoa!
Nailed it.
Very nice.
I don't actually know why that happened. Because the last time we did Jinjo hurling as well, it seemed like I tapped into the Jinjo very lightly and it still went flying. So I don't know what's going on there, but I'm not complaining.
Well, the Jinjos are magical, right? So maybe they amplify velocity whenever something
maybe
comes into contact with them.
They are in fact magical.
Yeah. So Dex, how do you feel about all the like hyping up Rare has been doing this year for the next big project?
Not happy.
No?
Because it's not gonna be Banjo.
Oh.
I know it's not gonna be Banjo. I see all the hype online, and I'm like, everyone's like, oh, here it comes, they're hyping it up. And I'm like, it's gonna be fucking Battletoads. I know it. It's either gonna be Battletoads or Kinect Sports 4 or whatever number it is they're on, or nothing.
What if it's gonna be like Perfect Dark minus one?
Oh my god, that would be even worse.
Yeah.
Because like if we made Battletoads, right?
Uh-huh.
They're making something that some people can enjoy. Not necessarily me, mm-hmm. but there are plenty of people out there who enjoy Battletoads. So I'll be happy for those people that like Battletoads.
Yeah.
But if it was like Perfect Dark again, I'd just be like, oh god, no.
Well, there's plenty of people that like Perfect. Well, plenty is maybe a little bit too great of a term, but there are people out there who like Perfect Dark.
No, I'm not saying there aren't people out there that enjoy Perfect Dark. I'm just saying the track record with the last time they tried to do Perfect Dark's not great.
But isn't the same true for Banjo, though?
Yeah. Yeah. This is true. I don't know.
And then there's also the fact that, I mean, if you want to play Perfect Dark, there's plenty of games out there that are like Perfect Dark. But for Banjo, that's not really the case. Oh no!
I caught a mouse.
Take the mouse.
I don't know how this happened, but it did.
The mouse is confused about it too.
You coming with me, mouse? We're going on an adventure.
No.
We're leaving him behind in Logbox.
Oh. That's even worse.
He's okay, he's fine. He's fine where he is.
Alright. He's a little concussed, but you know, happens to everybody.
So the police are still hanging out at Showdown Town.
Okay.
But
every step you take, they'll be watching you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly.
Thanks for that sting.
Don't worry about it.
I can't remember. It's really annoying. I can't remember if the police actually pose any kind of threat to me in this video or not, because it's been a while since I watched it. And it's so annoying because it's like, I'm like trying to show off how annoying the police are, and so far they've just kind of hung out and not done anything. I'm like, oh, come on, making me look really stupid. I take off 5 jiggies, put them in the bank.
Nice. Maybe you'll get arrested for jiggy fraud.
Maybe. Alright, put those jiggies in the bank, unlock some new Humber parts from Humber.
Yeah. Should've done your jiggy tax, Dex.
Oh man.
Now you're gonna be in trouble.
That's why the police are after me. Banjo didn't file out his tax return this year.
You didn't complete your O2E form.
Oh god. Wow. Wow. That was really good.
So wait, why was that jiggy in that dispenser? Because that's for a different level, right?
It's Trophy Thomas Jiggy.
Oh, right, okay.
Trophy Thomas Jiggy's put in a different dispenser because he's special or something. I don't know.
Well, yeah, Trophy's right in his name.
Yeah.
That means he's cool and my favorite character.
Yeah. No.
No. If there is, like, one thing I like about this game, it's how Showdown Town looks at night.
Like, you know what? Like, that's one thing about this game which I've kind of forgotten, which I had kind of forgotten about previously, which is how nice it looked at nighttime. It looks really good at nighttime.
I think this might be my favorite skybox in a video game, which is, like, faint praise, but it's just, it just looks so nice.
It is a good skybox.
Yeah.
It's really nice.
Because I think there's some parts in this game where it looks like a little, like, the early next-geniness really leaks through the cracks. Mm. Like, there's too much bloom and generic textures, stuff like that.
It's not too bad, because it's 2008.
Yeah.
So it's a couple years into the console's life cycle.
Yeah.
but it's still only like 2 years because the 360 came out in 2006.
2005, so. I think.
Was it that? Was it 2005?
I think so, because I think the Wii and PlayStation 3 came out in 2006.
Yeah, yeah. That's definitely right. So, Jordan, you're in for a treat. We're doing some crate collecting. Oh, as you can see, I bumped into the police officer. That was the thing that happened in this video. I bumped into him, but then easily just fucking drove away from him. Like, it was no threat to us whatsoever. But the police are really annoying because they kind of get in your way and you can bump into them really easily and they can go absolutely everywhere because they've got what are those things called? It's kind of, I don't remember the name for it, but it's kind of like a big cushion of air on the bottom, and it can go on land, not on water.
Jeez.
Yeah, so they can literally follow you nearly everywhere.
Can they also fly?
As you can see, he's driving away.
Oh, okay, good.
They can't fly, but I don't think flying is, bar putting something in the trolley and using that glitch.
Oh,
flying is not something that we'll be doing legitimately in this game.
Wait, but you can fly, you can adjust the trolley, right?
You can adjust the trolley, but the thing is, the trolley that you have in Showdown Town is actually kind of different from the trolley you use in the levels.
Oh, okay.
Like, the trolley you use in Showdown Town is like a set trolley.
Okay.
That gets upgrades every time you beat Gruntilda, which you can then use on all your other vehicles. But you can't then take, like, a modified trolley into Showdown Town.
Right.
That's just not happening.
I mean, that would be, like, really broken as well, because the first time you get a flying upgrade, you could just get all the other crates.
Yeah. Well, you can still do it.
But. Yeah, but it's a little harder than that.
It's a little bit harder, yeah.
Yeah. But what if, like, what if you jump, like, a really sick ramp, and then the police are like, oh, that ramp's too sick for us, and then is there any situation like that?
No, I think they will try to follow you literally anywhere.
Okay.
Even if you do a sick ramp jump.
Damn.
There aren't really that many sick ramp jumps in Showdown Town, but the couple of areas where I think that could happen, they probably will try to follow you off the jump.
Damn. That's hardcore.
Yeah.
You know, I saw a police chase once on the show Like Cops, where a guy tried to get away by driving into the water. He didn't get very far, obviously. What? But maybe he
got his car's on a boat.
Maybe he got that idea from this game. Oh no! Oh, thank goodness.
Oh yeah, almost lost that crate. Oh dear. Saved it. I'm a pro.
Very nice.
Yeah, that guy had obviously been playing too much Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts.
But can you blame him?
Yes.
Okay. I mean, yeah, don't play games for more than an hour at a time, after all.
Who says video games don't influence people to go commit crimes? It's absolutely not true.
Yeah.
Right after this, I'm going to go break in somewhere and steal a giant golden jigsaw piece. That's not true. Please don't arrest me.
Please.
So I did this for some reason, but I don't know why I did it, because there's a thing that's going to be in there later, but it's not there. So I don't know why I tried to get it twice. I was like, huh? I think I just forgot what it did. And was like, this is important. Like, wait, no.
Well,
but now you know it's there.
Everything in this game is physics-based, so maybe it got, like, stuck to the floor or something. Oh, no. Oh, okay.
It's all good. It's not. There's literally nothing in there at the moment.
Okay.
There's going to be something in there. There's going to be a way for us to use that later, but not for right now. All right. I don't know why. I just forgot. Been a long time, okay.
I wonder why they don't just, like, when you're in the cart, why they don't just lock all the stuff that's in the, like, in the wagon. Why they don't just lock it to it.
They just let everything that's in there slide around. Oh god, Mumbo! Oh dear. That probably shouldn't have happened.
No.
That didn't look good.
Is it supposed to be like that?
No.
Oh.
His eyes are not supposed to slide slowly back into
Because in like the last level they popped out.
Yeah.
So I thought maybe that was like a bit of continuity.
He does this thing where he takes his eyes out and juggles them. That's like his idle animation.
Okay.
But like he was mid animation and I spoke to him, so his eyeballs slowly flew back into his sockets.
Messed up.
Very good. Alright, that's it. Banjo Land, Act 2.
That's the museum, right?
That's the museum.
Yeah.
Museum's a pretty good level, but it still makes me have mixed feelings.
Oh.
But it's still good. I think.
Kind of like this mixed weather. Why is it only freezing over here?
Because we're over by the snowman, obviously.
Right.
Duh.
Top new.
Yep. Yep. Oh yeah, I drove off this with the regular trolley and forgot I wasn't in this trolley. I was like, whoops.
Great.
Better make a quick adjustment there.
So Dex, I don't want to blow your mind, but if you look at the top right of the UI right now with the where it shows you what you can do with the buttons, it kind of looks like a bear face.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I've totally never noticed that before. Alright, we got another thing we gotta do for Mr. Fit. God damn it.
He just said Stony and Roll Up in one sentence.
Hidden messages.
Yep.
That's subliminal messaging if ever I saw it. It's a conspiracy. So this is Nuts and Bolts version of Kickball.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but you remember that the classic minigame from Banjo-Tooie that everyone loved.
Right up there with Beaver Bother.
Right up. You know what? You take the fucking Donkey Kong 64 bullshit somewhere else. Anyway. So one thing that's kind of cool is that the game will actually let you take Log's choice vehicles and adapt them.
Okay.
Which is what we are doing right now. I know what I said about the Log Pusher last time we used it, but... But,
You should have called it Full Kit Wanker.
I should have, yes. I should have.
No.
But with a simple adjustment of basically making the area of things that the pusher can push, it actually makes it really good for this mission. And as you can probably see where this is going.
I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're gonna take all these balls and also this cow.
Maybe the balls are made of cow skin.
I'd hope not. I think that's illegal now.
Oh.
I don't think they've done that for many, many years.
I wouldn't know.
I wouldn't know either. I'm just bullshitting.
So you can adapt like the Log's Choice vehicles. Does that mean you could just completely overhaul them and turn them into a vehicle that you'd like, that's perfect for the situation?
Yeah, which is kind of what I've done at this point.
No, but like for this one, you
couldn't
only
do it. You couldn't do it in Log's in a Log's Choice challenge.
Okay.
Yeah, like it just grays out the option to create a new vehicle in these challenges. You don't even have that option. They don't even give you that creative freedom.
Dang.
Build on what we built. It's like, nope, you must use the thing we built or else.
Oh no. That guy should be on the floor crying right now trying to get you a yellow card.
So one thing that's kind of annoying about this mission is we've got a number that we've got to score to get a jiggy, but as you can see, we've surpassed that number, and you kind of don't really know what number you're supposed to be aiming for a Trophy Thomas trophy.
Right.
So you just end up kind of putting as many balls in there as you think is the right amount.
Yo.
So it doesn't actually tell you how many balls you need, but it's 10.
It looks like you're not in the blue yet, though.
I am, yeah.
Okay.
I scored a total of 11 points. I actually did that really quickly and then ended up with a minute and a half where I just kind of drove around nothing to do.
Oh, you can't end the mission prematurely?
No.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's not an option they put in this game.
Jeez.
They put a really good option on the menu, which is Return to Showdown Town, but apart from that, you really dropped the ball, no pun intended. What am I talking about now? Pun intended.
Definitely pun intended.
Definitely. Always pun intended.
Yeah.
Alright, it's time for us to meet an old friend.
Oh boy.
Here he comes.
I probably don't know this character.
You probably don't know this character. I do. That's because I'm a nerd. There he is. Oh, Grumbot. No, that's not him.
Get out of here.
It's Boggy.
Oh, hey, I know Boggy. He's like the horrible
I
dad.
I punched him by accident.
It's okay, he deserves it.
It's Boggy the polar bear.
Yeah.
And he's like the cleanup guy for Banjo-Land. Which is not a good job.
His face is real big.
Mm.
Does he have to do that all on his own?
It looks like it.
Oh.
But it doesn't really look like he's even trying slightly. He's just kind of... He's actually... It looks like he's actively taking trash from the bin and throwing it on the ground. That's actually the reverse of what he's supposed to be doing.
Well, imagine having to do, like, a job where... All right, you see a piece of trash, you go to pick it up, they knock it with your foot, and then because the physics are all fucked up, it flies like 100 feet further.
That wouldn't be good.
Yeah.
So this mission's kind of weird.
All
because
right.
You can literally pick any vehicle you want because they just leave this vehicle for you.
That is weird.
Over here. And it's literally the perfect vehicle to use for this mission, so... Why would you bother trying to build anything else?
Yeah. They've never done that before, have they?
No, this is the first time they've done it. And I can't remember if they do it again. Also, the bin's full of copies of Grabbed by the Ghoulies, which is quite funny.
Damn. Harsh but true.
Harsh but true, yeah. Sometimes the truth hurts.
Like when you get grabbed by the Ghoulies.
It was a really weird decision to, like, just... Like, if you're gonna do that, just make it Log's Choice.
Yeah, well, know? No, if it's Log's Choice, it has to be, like, a bad vehicle.
But that was actually a good vehicle.
Yeah, so like, that's why it couldn't be Log's
it's
Choice.
It's so
that...
fucking confusing. It's like, this game can't make its mind up. It's like, okay, we're gonna make you use these awful vehicles, and in this one specific mission, we're gonna give you a vehicle that's actually pretty good.
Yeah, but only if you notice it.
But only if you notice it.
How...
But of course, I notice it. I notice everything. Like, this Grumbot. Trying to sneak up on us. It didn't work.
You know, in like Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, a sort of running theme was that like all the characters are like jerks who are always making it more difficult for Banjo.
Yeah.
And I think they, in this game, that sort of leaked into the actual gameplay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at this messed up. A real Jinjo has been put on in the display cabinet. That's not good.
That's not good. I would have never noticed that.
Yeah. You would have noticed it because if you get close enough to the cabinet, there's like a massive fucking Jinjo hologram.
Oh, that's right.
Over
okay,
it. So
yeah.
It's like, oh, Jinjo's in there.
And also it shows up on the radar, right?
Yeah, it does. It shows up on the radar if you have the Specco Spy
okay.
attached to your car.
Oh wow, it was Bottles.
Yep. Bottles, well, I mean...
Bottles nearly killed a person.
That's fine, he had enough air for a few more hours.
Okay. So what are we doing? Oh.
This is a Jinjo taxi. This Jinjo taxi can fly, making it the best Jinjo taxi so far. Because you don't have to deal with trying to fucking steer it.
Makes the mission a little less taxing.
Yeah.
That's right.
That is right. You know what's kind of weird about this museum?
Wait.
Is it kind of has a lot more of a Banjo-Kazooie influence than any Banjo-Tooie influence. Like, there's very little Banjo-Tooie, like, actually on display.
Well, that's because Banjo-Kazooie is, like, a lot more iconic, isn't it?
I guess.
Because I think Banjo-Tooie didn't sell that well. Oh god.
I don't Yeah. I don't know. The confusing thing is I think that Banjo-Kazooie overall is like a more well recognized game than the sequel.
Yeah.
But then like the sequel was nominated for a BAFTA
Really?
Yeah.
Huh.
Not Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo-Tooie was nominated for a BAFTA. I don't know what for, probably game design or something like that, but yeah. So, I don't know, it just seems kind of weird to me for them to just leave out, like, most of one game for, like, a museum that's supposed to be dedicated to both past games? I don't know. I mean, there's enough Tooie references, like, scattered around, but, like, all of the big references are Banjo-Kazooie references.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Yeah, but then it's also, I think, that Banjo-Tooie just has less to it that's, like, really directly recognizable.
Yeah, that's... Yeah, probably true, actually, now I think about it. There's no like, one iconic thing from Banjo-Tooie that you can really grasp onto.
Like, the only thing I can think of, just off the top of my head, is the Mumbo Jumbo's daughter.
You mean,
Or, like, the Native American girl.
Yeah, Humble Wumbo.
Yeah.
They're not related.
Okay.
They're not related.
Oh, well.
They're actually married in this game, I think.
Oh, okay.
I think. I don't know if that was just, like... I don't know if I was just part of one of the... And we're going to teach this guy a lesson. No one fucks with us. I don't know if I was just, like, part of, like, the story of one of the...
Banjo-Kazooie novels, right?
No, yeah, all the levels have, like, their own contained stories, so I don't know if it was part of that or not, but it might be... Might just apply... In general, they might be married. I don't know.
Oh. And I guess Klungo is also, like, a recognizable Banjo-Tooie thing. Oh, no, wait, Klungo was in Kazooie as well,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he was in the first game. He's a carryover. Mr. Fitz in this, he's from Banjo-Tooie.
Great.
Yeah, he's the character we all wanted to see come back.
What about the part where you turn into, like, a... where you turn into, like, a... What was it, like a pest control van?
That's in here.
Yeah.
Like, there's a bunch of crates that have all got Banjo-Tooie on them. They've all got the Banjo-Tooie transformations on them. But, like, as far as, like, definite, obvious Banjo-Tooie references, like, that's the biggest one I can think of that's in this place. But that's, like you said, it's probably because, like, there's not... Well, actually, no, I'm wrong. There's the massive freaking test of strength thing, which was in Witchy World.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, so we're gonna ramp it.
Wow, Dex, first you fucked with that one purple guy, and now you're riding a motorbike.
This is it. I'm becoming edgy, finally.
Yep. Banjo's in the gang.
Yeah. Alright. Don't remember what's left to do. There's a few minutes left on the video, so I guess we're gonna find out.
Sons of Banjoarchy or something, I don't know. I was trying really hard, I couldn't think of anything. Oh.
Hell's Banjos. Alright, so we're gonna get our Trophy Thomas Jiggy, which completely misses the trolley.
Naturally. Trophy Thomas feels so, like, weird and out of place.
He does.
Like, he's much more of a... He's far closer to, like, I don't know how to put it, like, a Thundercats character, like a Saturday morning cartoon hero character than the rest of the cast.
He definitely feels like he doesn't belong to this game.
Yeah.
I would say that. Like, he doesn't feel like he belongs to Banjo-Kazooie. All the other characters kind of feel like they fit. But that might just be because, as far as I know, Mr. Fitz, like, no, not Mr. Fitz, Trophy Thomas is, like, the only new character.
That sounds right.
Whereas the rest of them are recurring characters, so that it might just be a case of because we've seen the rest of the characters in the context of the previous Banjo games, he feels weird because he's, like, the only new thing.
Yeah. Maybe, but I don't know. I feel like Trophy Thomas is, like, the one character in this game that would be out of place in, like as a plush doll in, like, a young girly girl bedroom.
Mm. Yeah.
That's how I'd put it.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, I get.
He's got more tune than the rest of the cast.
Yeah, which is so weird. No, like, Banjo games don't have tunes.
Yeah, except for Altitude.
Yeah, well, there's that, obviously.
Yeah.
But yeah, Banjo games don't have, like, an attitude to them.
No.
which is why I thought it was really weird when Banjo like made that one Saki comment, and I was like, "What did Banjo know that?"
Banjo, please.
That's not your thing. Leave that to Kazooie.
Yeah.
Anyways, I went through that whole bunch of stuff, and then right at the end, remembered I missed a crate.
Oh, what?
Oh. It's all good. That's a special trick I like to call trolley cancelling. It's a pro speedrun strat right. that I invented. Thank you very much.
Please give credit if you're going to be at AGDQ running this game.
Yep. Please give me credit. Has there ever been a speedrun? I'm actually interested to see a speedrun of this game now.
I don't know
how long it takes.
I don't know if there's a...
It could probably actually be done really quickly because of the trolley flying glitch.
Yeah.
Alright, what are we getting? Some good stuff.
Egg turret.
Bunch more cubes for me to create more abominations. That's all we're getting. And I think that about wraps it up. We've opened Naughty Acres Act 5. So not too much more to do for Naughty Acres, I don't think. We'll be going to the next episode. And that's it. Thank you all for watching, and we'll see you next time.
See you next time.